For example, if you have a fracture of the hand and you keep using the same hand for doing all your work, the healing is very slow. Similarly, if you have a heart or lung ailment and you still expect the heart and lung to keep on supplying oxygenated blood for all the other body parts to work, whether you are flogging the lung with the ventilator or flogging the heart with medicines, they tire out and the healing is delayed or doesn't happen at all. Putting such a patient on an extracorporeal machine helps them to revive, not only for the primary organ to recover, but if it is not recovering, there are other options like other mechanical circulatory devices or medicines which long term will help the patient. So a patient can live on very less function of the heart or lung, because these are very high capacitance organs, and once the body gets used to a poor heart function or a poor lung function, a patient can survive with some lifestyle modification. But when the sudden heart-lung failure happens, the body cannot cope immediately, because the body is used to having a good reserve of energy supply. We have to help the body to survive through that crisis, and the device to take over the function of the heart and lung machine is a machine called as the extracorporeal membrane oxygenator, or ECMO.